All right.
Take a
deep here goes breath. G500 4x4 convertible.
No.
Good morning, but not good morning from Canada as we had planned. We are currently in Amsterdam to do some serious modification on the G. I know you've seen the thumbnail, so you get an idea, but we won't say much more. But we are here and we're just trying to wait for our pickup here.
Pickup. And the pickup is here.
Thank you, dude.
Yo, nice.
Hey, Ben.
Nice. Good morning.
Thanks for the car.
Yes, no problem.
Really appreciate it. You know the best thing with Absolute Motors?
No.
Is that when you get to borrow a car from them, it has wires in case you run into bushes, you have extra lights, and I saw a shovel in the back. Great minds think alike.
Little, yeah, little brother of the Jeep.
Let's go explore Holland.
Yes.
Secret project, but we made it.
Shh.
Benny the racer driver killed it. It's kind of hard to selfie vlog when it's dark out, so you need a light, but we have finally made it here. It took us forever. We were stuck in traffic for God knows how many hours, so it's dark out now, and we have some work to do. Some serious work, and we're gonna go in and talk about it, see what the absolute people think.
It took a long time to come here.
No, but that's life. We just keep traveling. When we fail with travels, we travel some more. What have you done?
There's nothing anymore.
How are you?
No way. Back to empty.
You have to see it from the back.
Oh. That's perfect.
That's empty. So, a little bit of a backstory. When we first thought about what car to get, we were like, but we can't fit a G in the garage. Like, we shouldn't get a G.
How high is the garage?
The garage is like 2 meters.
In Monaco, yeah.
Yeah, so that was a problem. But then we figured that, I don't know how we got the brilliant idea. Let's just make it a convertible. Cut the whole roof off. Yeah,
you don't need the roof in Monaco, but yeah, everything is warm.
No, I saw this like photo of two guys in Saudi driving this super, super old G-Wagon.
Can you show the photo?
If I find it, here it is. And I'm like, oh, that is so winning. And I'm like, no, you can't do that. You can't take a 4x4 and just, mah!
Yes, you can.
But then again, I always like doing things that you really shouldn't do that you know, normal people don't do.
And those guys are always following on those ideas.
Yeah, exactly. So that was like, that was the reason we got this, because we figured we cut it and then it will fit in the garage, we can use it and it'll be awesome. But then we ran a bit short on time and we figured maybe we'll just do that later. Mm-hmm. But then we were like, no, let's just get it done. And when we missed the flight, I called Kenneth, I'm like, have you cut it yet? He's like, no, we're thinking about it tomorrow. That is why we're here now. So super last minute random coincidences. But of course I want to be here when we put a metal saw to a G. Because when I got this, I'm like, oh, like it's not like a true big project because it's not rebuilt enough.
Yeah.
So that's kind of the plan. Today we're going to take a metal saw and cut the roof off a G. 4x4. Brand new. Not brand new, but like almost brand new.
Push, guys, push.
Step one almost complete. Now we're gonna just move it out in the middle. And if you're wondering why we're not driving it, it's because the engine is getting some love as well. So we can get that bench paper of 800. If you have a convertible, you need to have a speed.
Yes.
Like, just imagine how much lighter it's gonna be once it doesn't have
How much lighter and faster?
Lighter, faster. And I'm just standing, I'm looking at it, imagining it a convertible. The G-Class 4x4 drop pad.
Bye bye.
Okay, roof rack for a G wagon for sale if anyone wants to buy it.
No.
Stripping weight for the drag racer. Carbon part on the roof for sale.
Is it that time where we say goodbye?
It's that time when everybody here is looking a little nervous. Me including, but we see the smile.
Yeah.
The smile that only comes from different ideas. So one final look. I remember what it was like to have a G with a roof.
I see the blades.
Oh. Ready?
Who's gonna do the first spa? Have you ever used one of those?
Yeah, but it's been a long time.
Damn! You seem ready.
Yeah, except I didn't like that it jammed. Okay, are we good to go?
Yes. Yes.
Climb.
Let's go.
All right.
Take a
here goes
breath.
G500 4x4 convertible. I have like a heartbeat of like 600. Yoon! G-Wagon medal!
Zero!
One there! Woo!
Wow! Let me take the space. There is the space.
I gave it a little bit of extra millimeter. Because this thing's a little wobbly. All right, Kenneth, next pillar is yours. Come on, Kenneth.
One pillar.
Yeah, I mean, it's a group effort.
What a crazy idea. You're not finished.
I'm deaf.
Huh? Are you deaf?
Yeah, right? It's way easier to, like, break things than to build things.
Yeah! Step number two. Finish. Is it?
Yeah, we can.
It's gonna get a lot lighter and faster.
Okay, let's go.
Woo!
Woo!
Okay, wait.
Yeah, man.
Ooh, that was
wow.
Good.
Who's the first?
Okay, G roof for sale.
Oh, we can put back the roof rack.
I think we should just leave it like this. Okay, now we gotta kill these last parts. I'm feeling it.
Oh yeah, totally.
Who feels excited about Benni?
Huh?
Yeah, Benni!
Benni!
Yeah. Woo!
Yes! Give it a kick!
Did I scratch anything? Oh, still attached?
Just the plate terms.
Oh, it's okay.
This thing with like disassembling a car is pretty easy.
Kick it! Oh no! He didn't sense. It was still attached.
That's okay.
Nothing is.
We're clearly not ninja material. Let's have a look at this thing.
3, 2, 1. Ta-da! Jump in now. Yo, what's up?
I've always wanted a very special car.
You should really have a low seat like this. It makes the whole difference.
I can already feel that I love this. 800 horsepower, like going nuts. I'm looking back, trying to like recognize the feeling of a car. This is before the transformation, but it doesn't feel like anything else. Of course, it's empty now, but thank you for encouraging me to do stupid things.
It was a pleasure.
They say life is all about smiling, and I've smiled a lot today, so I think mission succeeded. Now, okay, so then the plan is here. We're, of course, we're gonna get seats, so we sit a little higher. And then the windscreen's gonna be lowered to about here, because the original idea to do this came from the sizes of Monaco parking garages, where we couldn't park a G500.
Yeah.
So right around here, we can enter smoothly into the parking garages and still have a G500. And the good thing is, by doing this, we're saving 60 euros in valet parking every day we're in Monaco.
Yes. Oh, it looks so unreal from here.
I can feel that light. Oh, there you are. I'm so dizzy from all the sparks in my eyes. But I can feel the, I can feel how good it feels already. Yeah. It's like, you know, you, sometimes you know, there's always something on a car you don't like, but here I'm, I think once we like cut off and straighten, like do everything, it is such an insane combination of like a Rolls-Royce drop head and a G4x4. We're gonna add a couple Rolls-Royce twists to it. But I don't know, I'm kind of, I feel, have we filmed a lot? Should we end the vlog here?
Yeah, I think there would be nothing more exciting than this after.
I say we're gonna end the vlog here, because we're gonna just drive back to Amsterdam, jump on a plane in like a few hours to Monaco.
Oh, do we fly at 6 in the morning?
Yeah, of course we fly at 6, so hopefully we make this flight. But I hope you guys enjoyed being a part of this first part of the journey towards a beach cruiser G4x4. And yes, it's okay, you can think that we're stupid, but it's alright, because we're having fun, and we're smiling. And before we end, we have to say one thing. Thank you!
Thank you again!
They're probably gonna go home and like, dude, that, these guys are idiots. But that's okay. Thank you, absolutely. You guys are the best for helping out in every possible way, every time. So, we'll see you real soon. Ciao, adios, and goodbye from Lord Hans 2.0.
Ciao, ciao. Ciao, Roof. We don't need you anymore.